Hi guys, welcome to another episode of On the Radar with Fort Bliss MWR. My name is Chris Bone and I work for Fort Bliss MWR Marketing. Today I am welcoming to the show Miss Tephanie Hopper, and she is the Fort Bliss Army Volunteer Corps Manager. Welcome to the show. Thank you so much for stopping by.
Thank you, Chris.
So you have a bunch of exciting stuff coming up here in the first couple of months of 2020. Happy 2020,
by the way. Happy 2020 to you.
It is a new year and a new opportunity for everybody to become involved with their communities. And you're just the person to talk to about this kind of stuff. So April 19th through the 25th, you guys are supporting the Volunteer Week.
Yes, right? National Volunteer Week. We're celebrating our volunteers throughout our community by recognizing them for their selfless service.
Awesome. And how can people nominate individuals or groups for these awards?
Well, they can go to our Bliss MWR website and they can nominate individuals for their service in our community. Would you like to know the categories?
Yeah. Categories have we got?
Fort Bliss Volunteer of the Year, that's nominating somebody for the outstanding volunteer of an agency. For example, Army Community Service will have a Volunteer of the Year. 11th Brigade will also have a Volunteer of the Year. We also recognize outstanding youth. Those are 18 years and below. We also have the Ambassador Volunteer Award, those are volunteers that exemplify service outside of our gates. A new award we have is a Community Spirit Award, and that is for agencies who are doing group projects such as El Paso's Fighting Hunger Food Bank or Operation Santa Claus. And finally, we have the Outstanding Volunteer Family Award, and that's for, you know, siblings, mother and son, those who give to our community as well.
That's awesome. Now, how will those awards be presented? I understand April 23rd at 1:30 p.m. at the Centennial Banquet and Conference Center, you have this party planned for that day.
Yes, we have the volunteer ceremony starts at 1:30, and that award is usually presented by the commanding general or his designee.
Okay. Mm-hmm. All right. And so that's going to be a luncheon kind of a thing at the Centennial then?
It will be light hors d'oeuvres.
Excellent. Cool deal. Now, they can find you and the Army Volunteer Corps at Building 250 Club Road. And your phone number, in case anybody is interested in any volunteer opportunities coming up, is area code 915-569-5500. So that is, again, 915-569-5500. So moving on from the contact information, tell us about your Facebook. So you've been doing a lot of work to kind of grow the audience with your Facebook. What is the, how can people find you on Facebook?
They can look for it on Fort Bliss Volunteers Facebook page. And we do a lot of Facebook Lives. We also list opportunities that are available throughout the community where people can give back either in El Paso or on our installation.
That's awesome. And you mentioned the Lives. I noticed that you guys had been doing a lot of Q&As and stuff. And I love to see like a happy and positive message being put out there. And it's never been anything less than that. That's always a whole lot of fun to watch those Q&As. But the people that you have interviewed there are usually like volunteer managers from across the community. But I've also seen senior enlisted folks and also officers and stuff being interviewed as well.
Well, recently we had the Better Opportunity for Single Soldiers president on last week. We've also had the Tax Preparation Volunteer Manager on. And then we've also had the Coalition for the Homeless Volunteer Coordinator on, so that we can expound volunteerism, you know, not just for Fort Bliss, because everybody does, there's a variety of opportunities when you go outside of our gates.
Right, yeah, because I'm sure there are some opportunities within the gates of Fort Bliss, but there's just so many more once you step out the gate, right?
Yes.
And so you're the person that can help to facilitate all of that stuff.
Yes, that's me.
And part of the system that you use is the Volunteer Management Information System, or VMIS, right? And so you are the coordinator for VMIS. Now that's going to be the way that all of the actual official volunteer hours are tracked and assigned. Is that right?
Yes, that's where volunteers can track their hours, their awards, and their training. And that system will go with you wherever you go, from Fort Bliss to Fort Huachuca. This is like, we consider it like, you know, soldiers have the enlisted records. This is your volunteer record. And you can use that for, you know, skills and experience. If you're looking for jobs, if you're looking for scholarships, you can use that information as a part of VEMA, so you can schedule that information on your resume and things like that.
That's really cool. And so you put in 100 hours at Fort Bliss, but then you move to Fort Huachuca. You still are tracking those 100 hours career-wise, mm-hmm. Using the VEMA system.
Yes.
That's super cool. One other thing that you had mentioned that you guys do is the biweekly volunteer orientation. So walk me through something like that. So what does that look like?
The volunteer orientation is where I share opportunities with soldiers, family members, DOD civilians, as well as those El Paso civilians. So what I do in that orientation is I share, for example, the need for volunteering El Paso and Fighting Hunger Food Bank. They can ACS. We share those opportunities with our prospective volunteers, and we kind of connect them to those agencies. That's what the volunteer orientation is all about.
That's cool. So you can put names to faces and get a real feel for who these people are out there in the community that need this help,
yes.
This volunteer service. That's awesome. So one more time, April 19th through the 25th is?
Volunteer Week.
Volunteer Week. Okay, and now you can submit nominations for Volunteer of the Year, Outstanding Youth Volunteer, Outstanding Ambassador, Community Spirit Award, and Outstanding Volunteer Family Award, right?
Yes.
All right, and those nominations will be opening up January 17th, and they will be open through March 13th, with the awards presentation done on April 23rd at 1:30 p.m. at the Centennial Banquet and Conference Center over on East Bliss there.
That's correct.
All right, so one more time, Building 250 Club Road, and Miss Tephanie Hopper, the Fort Bliss Army Volunteer Corps Manager. And her phone number is, again, 915-569-5500. So give her a call, set up an appointment time where you can come in, get registered with the Volunteer Management Information System, and start tracking all of those amazing volunteer hours and great things that you are out there doing for the community. Thank you so much, Tephanie, for stopping by and talking to us about this. Let's do this again sometime soon.
We will.
All right, and we'll see you at the awards banquet.
All right, thank you.
Thank you so much,
thank
Tephanie.
You so much.
And thank you guys for tuning in to another episode of On the Radar with Fort Bliss MWR. My name is Chris Bone, and we'll see you guys again next week. Bye.